Afternoon.
Go on, then.
Civil matter, chaps. Nothing to do with you.
Say again.
Civil matter.
Well, we're here to prevent a breach of the peace, mate. Should one occur.
Breach of peace?
Should one occur.
The only people who are breaching the peace are the bailiffs.
Okay. Well, we've not been called by you, have we? We've been called by the bailiffs.
He tried to kill someone. He ran somebody over, yeah, so we've got to... Who did try to run over?
It's a crash landing.
It's a crime.
Confronted by a large group. Let's speak to folk. We'll get to the bottom of it, yeah?
No problem.
All right.
Thank you. Why are you assisting bailiffs? Are you acting as police officers or constables?
Are you under your oath today?
And have you sworn on your oath?
We're here to prevent a breach of the peace, mate.
So who's causing a breach of the peace? These have come to somebody's property causing a breach of the peace.
Right.
Right, so do your job. You're a public servant, do your job.
And I'll mute you. Act as a human being.
All these are working for the corporations.
The premises they were tending,
you,
the person that they were tending for does not listen to the premises.
You and you, you're three missed payments away from losing your house. Do you understand that?
We'll be on your doorstep.
You could be in debt at any given time. These people work for corporations, right? They do not work for the people. You do. So do your job. That's it.
That's all we're asking.
Wake up and do your job. Who did he run over? Him. That man there.
We've got on video. We've also got him.
You can't do anything because I'm trying to speak to him. You're obviously then speaking to him. I've got one pair of ears like you on top.
I understand that, yeah.
Alright, well, just let us do our job. But your job is to keep the peace, like you just keep saying.
They've broke the peace. They're breaking the peace by trying to force entry into somebody's property.
That's what you're telling them to do.
They have got no right to force entry.
You've got the relevant paperwork from the court.
It's not relevant.
Then it's...
What paperwork's that from the court?
No
bailiff in this country for a debt can gather a warrant off a judge. No one can. It's only for a commercial debt they can grant to full centre.
Not a chance to speak to the judge.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing.
Remember, gave me your own
proper paperwork, sir. He had 96 warrant.
Is it triplicate?
Is it? Oh no.
That's not a warrant. That's a master's piece of paper. That is not a warrant from the courts.
Fraudulent.
They're all acting under fraudulent. That's a fraudulent instrument in your hands.
Just do me a favour. Just step out of my personal space, yeah?
Okay, mate.
All right, give me some space in which to work.
You're just trying to video.
All right, that's fine. I've no issues you videoing it. Just let me do my job. All right, thank you.
It's a fraudulent instrument.
Move away, please.
Protect control of drugs.
Fraudulent instrument.
Now, Louise, where's your paper?
No, you threatened him.
Louise?
You threatened him.
Louise?
He did. He's the guy that threatened him, coming all high and mighty.
What judges took responsibility for this, sir?
Was it written up on the situation?
It was a debt to attach, and I've got some support with this, Darren West.
Yeah, I think he's found the responsibility at the moment.
Darren, Mr. West doesn't live at this premises, though.
Gentlemen here that would like to get off the
job. Mr. West doesn't live at the premises, though, officer. There's no evidence that Mr. West lives at this address.
Obstructed the highway, Mr. Roberts.
What evidence have you got to the Mr. West's address?
Excuse me, he's obstructed this gentleman.
Can you just move out of the way, folks, and we don't get anybody injured? That's the last thing we want him to say.
This is all the receipts for everything else that belongs to her. Nothing belongs to her. So basically, then, as you're aware, you cannot seize anybody else's property for somebody else's debt.
Right.
So this is basically clarifying everything within that.
Did he give this address when he was obviously dealt with by the police?
Well,
I'm sure he did, because there's a warrant executed here.
Maybe at some time.
Right, well, there you go.
Maybe in the past.
He doesn't live there, though.
He's not on a tenancy agreement. He's not registered living there. all the stuff he's registered with.
We'll have a look at his manner of driving.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
We'll sort one thing out to the town.
There's a crime just been committed there. There's an actual crime just been committed there. This isn't a crime, you see.
This is for the civil debt. This is a civil debt.
No, it's a civil debt.
Right, I know.
If people behave themselves, then there's no need for the cops to call, is there?
Well, do you know what? No, in fact...
Just hang on a minute. Just hang on a minute. There's a group here of probably, what, 15 to 20 people. Some of you are obviously wearing masks to hide your identity. Yeah.
No, no,
I would suggest that is intimidating.
Do you know what the thing is? You want to hear the phone calls, you've been intimidating to a woman on her own. Is that not intimidation? Ring up, say that. Just hang on 1 second, please, could I just give you your time?
Yeah, go on.
He turned around and he said, bring the effing police, bring whoever, I'm going to smash your door off, whether you like it or not. Right? Now, I'm not being funny, that was this morning. She's not had any contact with him since then, so he's rung her up this morning, giving her threats. So I'm not being funny, but that's not right.
But she knew she was coming, didn't she? Or that she knew that they were coming.
Well, do you know what? We spoke to you guys, yeah? Something's gone on with you, is that I think... She's rung you, spoke to the courts have said you cannot break entry to your home, right? The courts have specifically said that. The courts have said you can resist.
Do we know who has been spoken to at the courts?
Louise? Who did you speak to at the court? The fines officer it was.
Do we know him by name? Or?
No.
There'll be more than one.
Right, yeah. Well,
but no third party interlooper, which is a private bailiff, can force entry.
Let me read this.
You're reading Marston's piece of paper. It's not from the court.
Where's the official court? It's Marsden.
Do you know what a court warrant looks like? No, I'm being serious. No, do you know?
Got in some intelligence.
So why are you reading that then? Because that is not a court. That is not a court instrument. That is a piece of paper printed from Marston's, who is a third-party interloper.
They are not your master.
And I'm not being given the opportunity to read.
What does that say on there? Does that say from the court?
It says Marston's. I know it says Marston's.
So you see that, don't you? Right. Yeah?
That's what I'm trying to explain to you.
Give me a minute, mate. Yeah, please.
There's all the seats, so nothing in that house can be seen, not one item.
Not one bit of paper with from the courts.
No, you go
this is where all the fraud's been committed.
He's saying, because all the items have all been on higher purchases.
That's not a warrant.
Thank you, yeah.
Yeah, affirmative. We're just trying to get to the bottom of it. The issue is the numbers here. Obviously, I've only got one pair of ears.
They're not legal documents, they're not from the court. They print their own warrants.
Yeah, Roger, just be mindful when they come onto Walbrook, there is quite a group who come flying on.
Can you have a look at this, officer?
Just give me a
minute. What's all this you sorted out? Well, if you watch him driving, he ran somebody over.
We saw this out.
He was onto a highway and nearly run somebody over, spinning his wheels on his car.
We'll sort it out because we sorted
it. If he doesn't get prosecuted, there's something seriously wrong with it. Because camera evidence doesn't tell lies, does it?
That depends on the circumstances.
Hold the law side of it out.
You need to uphold the law, aren't you? I can read your oath to you if you need reminding of it.
For a bailiff to force entry, they need an EX96 form signed by a judge.
Just a minute, mate. I'm trying to read and you're blobbing him here. Yeah. I've got this blobbing him here as
well. You want to take that out because that can cause cancer.
All right, mate.
And that's for your benefit, not mine.
Right, OK. Well,
Google
I'll make that decision, won't I?
Well, you need to Google it.
Well, I'll make the decision, won't I?
Your son at the Home Office isn't telling you.
Well,
hey. Hey.
Not tactical, is that mate?
Not,
just
a finger.
There's
THU
on the side of it.
I didn't see the finger,
I'm not
in the front.
It's all false documentation.
More intimidation.
Oh, right. I think the officers know, don't they, that there's no standing there, that's why it's taking so long.
No. Are you getting someone else to look at the paperwork, aren't they? Let's go video what's going on.
It's not a court paper. It's not a court document.
Not a court document, it's not lawful.
Yeah. Come on in.
Have we got it?
There's fraudulent instrument in his hand there. Fraudulent.
Is that an official court document?
Oh, yeah.
They're printing their own warrants.
That's what's the thing about that crowd.
Yeah,
off
the road, please.
We're moving to the next court. You're not joined up to do this, have you?
No.
It's this bailiff. They've come with their own printed warrants.
the marshals on it.
Somebody film him.
Can
I make sure they get out whatever
he's
saying?
And what proof have you got that Mr. Westwood's at that address, sorry? Yeah? Obviously not, no. We've seen the badge now.
You're not so gobbing now, is it? You're not so gobbing now, are you?
Pretty mouthy on the phone all the time, wasn't
he? He's running scared now. He doesn't like intimidation, does he? Does Mr. Roberts feel intimidated? No comment.
Just like everybody else did.
Are you intimidating your parents?
Do me a favour, please. I can't have a conversation with him while you're prattling him here, can I? Well, you can ask him in a minute, can't you?
He'll drive off probably, like he did last time. He's too scared to answer questions. Hi, Mr. Roberts. We keep going then.
Need to wake up to all the fraud. What's second place?
We have had a phone call again. He's got the cash waiting.
He's not legal documents.
I've got the email.
Signed by Marsden, PS, I love you. That's all we are.
Put it to be a signature on it.
And the inventory that they've got to say he's not here, he doesn't live here. They've got no evidence that this guy lives here.
Well, hang on a minute. Explain why the wife was. He gave the address.
Yes, but because he was here.
Has he got children here?
Yes, he has, yes. The Matista children, my sister, Louise Jennings, is on the tenancy agreement. Right. My sister, Louise Jennings, owns whatever goods the inventorized when they came on Thursday. Been to see the solicitor with the inventory. The document that they gave on Thursday is not even a legal document. The solicitor said that herself. It's not.
£200 last week. He said, no, I can't take it. I need £400 or I'm seizing £4,000 worth of goods. At the end of the day, he's basically told me he's seizing everything out of my house, even the computer.
You're not supposed to be assisting the bailiff.
I'll tell you again, we're here to prevent a breach of the peace.
Right, so people are
do you know what goods are?
What you put up for sale or by auction. It's her property, it's not goods. It's property.
Property, yeah.
It's not goods. You need to learn the definition of goods and property.
Thank you very much.
This is a girl.
This is a girl.
Well, you've got footage. I have got footage. Just go on YouTube, you'll see it.
The inventory that they left of it should be there, another paragraph of paper. There, the solicitor is set.
None of that stuff can be taken. It's all white goods. White goods in there, which belongs to the kids.
They can't take children's stuff.
How can you choose all that?
It's not a legal document.
Everything's.
Even a solicitor has said that.
You have no right.
What we need to do is move away from here.
Okay. Well, what do you want to go then?
Yes, I think they're going.
They're not. They want to go somewhere else and talk in private.
You're not getting nothing. Goodbye.
Mr. Roberts wants to speak in private.
Mask on.
Paul.
This lad here. What's he called? Paul.
Mr. Roberts wants to speak in private. Bye. Get him fuck off.
Mr. Roberts wants to talk where there's no
that way. That way.
Should be assisting these plans, Mr. Cook.
We've got a job to do from surfing the course.
What if that was your daughter or your
daughter? I'm not getting involved in it because I don't know the circumstances of the warrant, do I?
There's no warrant. That's the problem. But nobody will arrest them for using fraudulent instruments. What these corporations are doing.
Oh, I'm not interested in your opinion about corporations, pal, to be honest.
Guess where you're going?